Leon, you really gotta take care of that beaver cut, buddy. I don't think it's really working for you in 2016. But I'm not a stylist. What the hell do I know? Welcome back, guys. Resident Evil 4 time. Oh, look, we got a note. Letter from Ada with a little kiss mark on it. Ooh. Once a Plaga egg hatches, it's nearly impossible to remove it from the body. But if it's before it hatches, then it can be neutralized by medication. If it does hatch, you might be able to get it out by surgery before it turns to an adult. But it won't be easy. There's a high chance you won't survive the operation. As far as I know, the girl was injected with the egg before you. Her time is ticking. You should prepare yourself for the worst-case scenario. I refuse to accept it. I'm Leon S. Kennedy, bitch. You don't know what I'm capable of. Hi, merchant.
Welcome. Got some rare things on. What are you selling?
Alright, let's sell everything we have. Did we combine the crown? I think we did. Salazar family crown, 48,000. That's what I predicted, right? Haha, go me.
Ah.
Bye.
Thank you.
Is and we can get rid of all this crap too.
Is that all? Is that all?
Alright, 456,000.
Come back.
You know what? Before we go into the tune-up menu, I gotta remind myself of what I actually want to reload. We're definitely gonna tune up the broken butterfly. And we'll probably tune up the ammo capacity on the sniper as well, because why not? I'm probably gonna want that max before too long. And, yeah, that's really all we need to worry about, I guess. Alright.
What are you buying?
Oh, Red 9 has firepower. Very good. 45,000. That's a spicy meatball. But it's the last regular firepower upgrade for it, so I guess it makes sense that it's expensive. And then we just gotta get a capacity upgrade, and then we can get that sweet, sweet exclusive upgrade that will really pimp out the firepower. Of course, we want this thing pimped out as well. Reload speed. We actually, we don't have a capacity upgrade for it right now. I thought we did. That is balls. That is hairy balls on my face, guys. I don't like it at all.
Is that all strength?
Striker is going to get pimped out as soon as humanly possible. So you can see, even just doing these three weapons, that was like 150k that we just dropped on a couple of upgrades for these weapons. It gets pricey as shit. And then we have this guy, of course. Let's, oh man. I was going to go just pimp out everything on this guy, but I wasn't, like, remembering exactly how expensive this shit gets at this point in the game. We'll definitely do capacity, because that gives us a couple free shots, and I think we might actually need him in this chapter. And firepower, it's only 2 for 30,000. But we'll still have a bunch left over. I think we'll be okay. I'm going to do it.
All strength?
We just won't do anything else. Reload speed is, like, pretty worthless on this thing, and capacity we'll use as needed. Otherwise, I'm just gonna worry about it, like, getting maxed out when, you know, everything else is taken care of, and it's the only thing that I have left that I care about. We'll get to that point in the game. It might take a little bit, but we'll get there, guys. Fuck that tower. I am not looking forward to it. Luckily, it's still a decent ways off. Let me check my inventory. How many frag grenades? I have one frag, one incendiary grenade, and a bunch of flash. That's pretty nice. At least I've been able to hold on to those for a decent amount of time. And we still have a buttload of healing. I do enjoy that. Let's just get this a little squared away. It was getting a little out of control there. Now it looks a lot better. Alright, so this area is weird. I think I mentioned before, I'm not, like, the biggest fan of this particular area coming up. It's just, like, I don't know, there's something about the design of it that bugs me. But it is fun getting to fight Ganados again, so I can't complain too much. And I'm gonna take this dude out. Easy peasy, just like that. Oh, shit! I didn't know you were standing right there. That was close. Should be dead from that. Okay, good. Oh, that's a great start. That dude almost caught me off guard. Jesus. The thing about this area is that normally if you're sly, you can get up there and do like a surprise grenade on all the guys hanging out by the fire. But I don't know if it's gonna work out that way on pro mode, guys. It could very well not work because they all have like a heightened state of awareness. These are the kind of things that I could never be prepared for. We're just gonna have to experiment and try our best. I guess I'll go ahead and get... See, an incendiary grenade doesn't really cut it here. We're gonna have to use the frag if we want to get the full effect here. So I'll get it, like, ready to go. But we may have to switch back to, like, the shotgun or something if this doesn't go well. I think so far we're good. Okay. Now, I always mess this up. This is just like the part in the castle where you try to hit all the dudes with one grenade, but I never quite get them all. Oh, they saw me already. Yeah, see? Okay. Okay, well, I kind of messed up the camera work there. I think I actually did touch all of them, but they didn't all die to it. It's a little bit of the old bullshit right there. But, man, they dropped a lot of loot that I do not want to miss out on, so... I'm not gonna dick around too much here. Let's grab this since I'm right here. These other guys didn't come over. I don't really know why. That actually may have worked out in my favor, though. Yeah, just stand there like idiots, and I will be happy to pop you from here. Let's get around right quick. Ah, yes, sir. Shut up. We have time to finish this dude. Okay. Get the monies, get the ammo. Alright, I'll take it. That costs one grenade and, what, a couple handgun bullets? Not bad, guys. Not bad at all. Now, before we proceed, we're gonna do a roundup here. There's a lot of crap in this area, and I'm getting old, guys. I don't remember shit very well anymore. I don't know where it all is. So we're just gonna have to basically wall crawl. I think there's one of these things we can open somewhere. Like a cupboard or something. And also, did I get the barrel that was on top of this platform? Because I'm starting to think I didn't. Let's double check. Oh, I did! Okay, I'm an idiot. I know I didn't do it at first because I didn't want to make the noise, but I don't even remember when I did it now. Let's come back here. Is there a cupboard back here? Somewhere we could open? This thing, maybe? No? Maybe I'm making that up. Somewhere there is an item up in the tree, though. There it is. Bird's nest, right here. Grab a spinel. And we already got the velvet blue from the well over there, so maybe we're good in this area. Is there anything up here? Any errant barrels? Nah. Not much happening there. Where's that... There's something in this area that, like, slides open. I swear to God, I'm not crazy. It's locked. Offer the sacrifice to the lion. And reload. Always reload, guys. Oh, maybe that item I'm thinking of is back here. Here's another well. There's nothing there. That's where we're gonna go when we're done looking around here. I want to take one more quick peek around here. I feel like I'm missing something, and I hate that feeling. I never want to have that feeling. It's like the worst feeling. Maybe not as bad as like syphilis, but it's up there. Syphilis would probably feel pretty bad. I've never had syphilis, guys. I'm proud to say. I don't know about you, but yeah. Okay, well, I give up. If there is another item out there, I can't find it. And I don't think there is. I think I'm making that up. Let's mash the square button so we can jump down into this place. Alright, here we go. This place, it's... I don't know what it is about this. It's like, there's something about this place that just bugs me. Up ahead rests the offering to the lion. Thanks for the heads up on there. It just feels like so... I kind of want to say, like, out of place compared to the rest of this game. In the way it's designed. I can't really justify that. I don't know. Anyways... Let's get started here. We're gonna try and draw these guys up towards us. Hi. Gotta be real careful because there's freaking bear traps everywhere. And a chainsaw guy. Oh shit! This dude came up so fast. God, I'm still not used to that. There we go. Anybody else coming from behind? Very well could be. Oh, and there's a box back. How the hell did I miss that? I saw it. Wait, there's two boxes. What the fuck? How did I miss both of these? What am I doing? Like I'm drunk right now. I swear to God, I ain't been drinking, guys. Oh, shit. Oh, man. That was too close. Don't you... Jesus Christ. All right, they're bunching up really quick. I got real lucky there. Like, real lucky. Stop throwing shit. Animation, invincibility. Yeah. Okay. You're gonna sprout, aren't you? Yep. Very good. Bring out two of them. Gives me a great excuse to use up one of these things. Screw you guys. Now, the really nice thing about this area here is that the chainsaw guy usually doesn't come down and come at you right away, because there's something stupid about his AI that makes him just sit up there. What the fuck? What the fuck? Where did you come from? Are you fucking kidding me with that shit? That dude didn't exist a second ago. Oh, I swear to God, guys. I'm lucky I didn't die from that. Okay. Yep. Go ahead and sprout. Why not? Tell you what, we're gonna snipe your dumbass. We're gonna snipe your buddy down there, too. He's gonna pay the price for you pissing me off. Hope he doesn't drop anything good. He didn't. Alright. So let me go ahead and reload this. Because we're probably gonna use this to take out Chainsaw Dude, too. But I don't want to do that just yet. Because I want to be able to get up to him quickly to pick up what he drops when he dies. And before we do that, we're gonna run down... How do we get there? Hold on. We're gonna wrap around this way, and then we can come over here. Grab that. And here we go. This is what I was looking for. Pretty nice item down here, cash-wise. We got the Staff of Royalty, which is what your mother calls my penis. Just being honest with you guys. And now we can start taking out these bear traps so that we can move freely without getting our pickies cut. Because that would be one of the dumbest ways to take damage in this game. It's a goddamn bear trap. Happens sometimes with alarming regularity. Sometimes they're hidden pretty well, but these ones kind of stick out, so it's another nice thing about this area. I give this area too much shit. I can't quite put my finger on what it is that bothers me about it. It's just like the overall aesthetic. I don't know, I'm just being a whiny bitch, guys. I'm sorry. I apologize. I'm a bad long couch. Okay. Let's get up here in the corner. There's an herb over here. Yep, a red herb. And I think that's all the major things we needed to collect in this area. So now we're just going to be a cheese dick and take this guy out from here. Because he's dumb. He lets us do it. Are you kidding? Is that a joke right now, what just happened? Wow, game. That was some next level bullshit right there. That's what that was. I'm impressed. I can't even be mad, because that was like some ingenuity right there. That's the same kind of fucking ingenuity that got humans to the moon. That's how impressive that bullshit was. I can't complain, they're giving me a free chainsaw guy here. Come on, Dr. Salvador, get your ass up. This is very cheeseballish, but we gotta be smart about it, guys. Sometimes this is a game of patience, you know? Not sure how many headshots it'll take to take this guy out on pro. I'm hoping not too many, because I don't want to waste all my damn sniper ammo. Although, I'm trying to think ahead. I'm not sure when the next time is that we'll really need the sniper. There's always places where the sniper's nice. But I don't think we're going to necessarily need it again for a little while. Alright, we're going to give him one more shot to the dome, and if that doesn't take him out, then we'll probably whittle him down with pistol shots. Yeah, that's about all I'm willing to waste on that. That was like 7 shots to the head. And with our trusty new stock, we should be able to land these shots with a pretty good degree of accuracy. Like so. Oh, okay, that actually went perfect. Oh, I love me. I'm the best guy ever. 10,000 big ones, and as soon as we climb up here, it spawns more people. Hey, yellow worm! That's nice. Fuck you guys. I'm actually gonna drop something on you because you're all bunched up down there. And I don't want this grenade. I don't know if this will actually... This might backfire big time. Here we go. Okay, I think that actually worked. I was afraid it was actually gonna blow up, like, on the wall right there and catch me on fire. Like, if I just caught the whip of it right there. No, that actually went pretty okay. Yes, I see the shiny on the pedestal right there, but I'm deliberately not picking it up just yet. Problem here is we can't really shoot these guys from up here, and I'm not going to leave my fortified position, so... This is actually probably the best way to handle this. Nobody's coming up behind me. Totally stabbed her through the wall. Elite hacks, guys. Elite hacks. You guys should be about dead by now. Give it one more go. Is that it? I think that's it. Oh, no, it's not quite it. Alright, let's get out of here. I wanted to kick her. Oh, that's gonna fuck me. Oh, that was so close to fucking me, guys. Oh, I'd have been an angry long couch. The raised ladder context-sensitive button took priority over the kick. What a bunch of shit. Hey, it's another chainsaw guy. How about that? We're gonna introduce him to our buddy, the Striker. Although, we don't have any extra ammo for this. That kind of sucks. Well, this will be enough to take him out, but... hopefully it doesn't take too much. Alright, let's do it this way. Knock him down. And then pour headshots. Knock him down. And then shoot him in the asshole, because I can't see his head now. Okay, good. Excellent. Hey, and a hand grenade! Love it. See, this is the payoff for taking it slow and deliberate, guys. We're actually doing really well. Aside from that bullshit fire-breathing guy that just spawned in out of nowhere over there. Alright, key to the mine. That spawns a whole new wave of people, which is why I didn't pick it up. But now these should be the only people we have to deal with, really. Back off. Oh, y'all can back off. I think some of them might come up behind us now, though. So I'm really gonna have to be careful here. Okay, so far, so good. Maybe they don't go for those stairs unless we head for them ourselves, which is just fine with me.
Cogelo!
Cogelo! You know, this is really, really stupid, guys, but every time I hear Cogelo in this game, it jogs a memory I have of a post on IGN from way back in the day. The IGN message boards. I don't know if any of you guys ever posted there. That was actually, like, one of my major haunts when I was much younger, around the time this game came out. But I remember somebody made a post saying that they heard the Ganado saying Cogelo in this game, and they thought that they were saying Go Halo. Which was, like, kind of a... I don't want to say it wasn't, like, a direct competitor to this game, but back in the day, you know, the Xbox and the GameCube had kind of a big rivalry, and one of the big things people would talk about was, like, Resident Evil 4 versus the Halo series, because everybody was like, oh, Halo's the best series ever, we gotta go play that on Xbox, you can only play it on Xbox. And people were like, nah, but Resident Evil 4 is, like, the best game ever made, and it's only on GameCube. It was before it came out and everything else. And it was just kind of funny that the dude was like, I think they were talking about Halo and Resident Evil 4. And everybody's like, that doesn't make any sense. And that's the whole story. Like I said, it was dumb. I just thought I'd share it. I kind of miss those days, guys. They were simpler days. I just really love the GameCube era. I mean, what a fucking great era, guys. So many classic games. That was around the same time that the Game Boy Advance was in full swing, and the DS was coming out soon. And the Game Boy Advance and the DS together are, like, maybe the best library of all time. The best gaming library. So this one's a little different than the trap we dealt with like this before, because I don't think we can actually shoot these out yet. Yeah. Which is a little weird. Like, I don't know why it's programmed differently, but it totally is. Maybe it's because there's a second component to this trap, where we're gonna get jumped by some Plagas as soon as we go in. Luckily, I know how to deal with it. Flashbang them, and you actually do have a pretty fair amount of time to take care of this. So, just keep your cool. Make your shots count. And it's done. Alright, did you boys drop anything? No, but we got some cash monies in here. And there's a certain spot somewhere in this level. I never remember exactly where it is. I'll point it out when we get to it. I don't think it's here. Yeah, okay. Moving on. I always thought it was kind of funny, though. They, like, you can cheese dick the previous trap room like that, but not that one. They make you do it for real. Okay, what do we got here? We got stuff on the ground. We've got barrels. Velvet blue. And you know what? I want to say, I think there's another spinel right up in this thing. It's somewhere. There's one hidden somewhere in here. Is it this? No, because I'm not getting the red dot sight on that. Oh, it's up there. There it is. You can actually see it hanging off the pot right there. Let's get a little closer. Yeah, you guys see that shiny right there? It's gonna be a tough shot though. I'm not getting my red dot sight on it. Normally it lights up like the freaking 4th of July to let you know that you're on it, but it's not working here. Let's try from the other side. What the fuck? I don't remember having this much trouble with this thing before. You can see it shining in there, though. It's definitely there. Oh! Just kind of right there on the side there. It showed up for like a second. That's solid. There it is. Come on. It's like so finicky. I don't remember having this much trouble with this thing. What is this about? Oh, it's kind of like... It's hidden so well. It's like at the top of the pot. What the fuck? I'm not getting the solid light from any other angle besides right here, and it's only barely working from right here. It's not going to give us that contact until we get that solid light on it. Oh, it's like right there on the left side. If you could just kind of skim it. Got it! Jeez, that was like way harder than it should have been. Fuck. Whatever, we got it though. It's done! Let us GTFO. Okay, one of my favorite parts, the minecart section. We're gonna play some Donkey Kong Country, guys. I actually like that game a lot. This is nothing like it. This part can go, like, a couple different ways. It can be, like, the easiest thing in the world or the hardest thing in the world. And a lot of it is honestly dependent on luck. It's like how many Plagas you get, how vicious they attack you. I'm assuming Pro is just gonna be, like, butt-fuckingly hard. These dudes are gonna be all throwing shit at me and everything. Yeah. Okay. So the problem here is I don't have a ton of shotgun shells, and that's gonna be my downfall more than anything, I think. Okay, that's a good start. Hopefully they drop a bunch for me. You can try and use the pistol if you're brave, but man, it's tough. Back there. I try to just stay in the back. Hang out back here. Use the shotgun to shoot the projectiles out of the air. Okay, just to make sure I don't mess up the QTE, I'm just gonna shoot this thing out of the way. Let me jump over! I wanna grab that shit! Okay. Let's get back! Get back! Oh my god, there's two guys in my cart. There's also some shotgun shells up here that you really wanna grab if you can. Definitely putting yourself in harm's way, though. I got him. Fuck you. And then, of course, the handgun ammo. Right here. Oh, shit. Oh, that's bad. That's real bad. Please die. Oh, God. Oh. This sucks. This sucks big time, guys. Alright, let's make this mixture. And we're gonna try and throw this as fast as humanly possible. Fuck you! God, the bitch got me again! Damn it all. Oh. That animation. Invincibility, guys. That's what it's all about. Fuck you, Plagas. Ugh. Reload real quick. Come on, come on. Okay. Fuck. Don't want to miss the thing that Chainsaw Guy dropped, because that's 10,000 big ones. Got that too? Oh, Jesus. Get in my back. There's another Chainsaw Guy. Is there normally two of them here? I'm actually not sure about that. Shit. We might have to switch to some TMP power here. As fast as humanly possible. Done. Got him. Oh, and they let me collect it from there. That was nice. Oh, shit. This is gonna kill my accuracy. Okay, it's not working. I'm just gonna stop. Ride! It's like a roller coaster! Here we go. Okay, I heard this is really hard on Pro. What button is it? Square! Mashing, mashing, mashing! Mashing, mashing, mashing! Mashing, mashing, mashing! Oh, we made it! Thank God. I've had a couple people tell me that they actually failed that button mashing sequence right there because it was so unexpectedly hard on pro mode. And I'm here to tell you guys that if I had failed that after doing reasonably well up to that point, I would have punched all the babies I could find. All the babies in like a 3-mile radius, they all would have been fucked. Okay, here's that spot I was talking about. So, this is so weird. I honestly don't know the story behind this. I don't know if this is like a leftover glitch or something they intended to be kind of hidden. You can't see anything here, but if you come over here and just spam this button, you get a shitload of small amounts of pesetas. And there's like no indication that it's there. You just gotta kind of know it. Really weird. I don't think there's any other spot like that in the game. That's why it stands out to me. You got the Stone of Sacrifice. That's what we needed. Alright. We're about done in this area. I'm glad that that's over. Not that the next part is all that much better, because it's not. It's actually going to be probably more annoying, if, you know, if anything, but... back out here. I still feel like I'm missing something. I hate that feeling. It's alright, though. You know, I don't know where, like, every single little spinel is in the game, guys. If I end up missing one every now and then, it's not the end of the world. I should still have probably enough money to do everything I want by the end of the game. And that'll be the end of Chapter 4-3. That was actually shorter than I remembered. Hit ratio 64? Are you fucking kidding me? That's awful. I feel like I did a lot better than that. That actually really pisses me off, like, in a major way. Like, I'm upset. I'm gonna go cry in the corner now, because I didn't think it was perfect by any means, but I thought it would be better than 60-fucking-4. I mean, I feel like I landed most of those TMP shots. I landed most everything else. I didn't whiff that much. Man, that brings me down, guys. I'm gonna go listen to Linkin Park. Thanks for watching, guys. I'm Dude Long Couch. I'll catch you guys in 4-4, which is gonna be a good one, suffice to say. I'll catch you guys then. Peace.